This is the Pulse of St. Louis.
Welcome to the Pulse of St. Louis. I'm Shirley Washington. You know, Access Point is making it possible for young people in the Gateway City area to secure careers in the tech industry by providing resources they need to achieve success. In fact, superstar rapper and St. Louis native Nelly is using his voice to raise awareness about the program. Let's listen.
Technology is everywhere. Music, sports, video games, and everything in between. And some of the best companies in the world are working with your school to train tech leaders of the future. It's a fast track to a high-paying, successful career. A technology job can take you where you want to be.
Joining us now, Ron Doherty, CEO of Doherty Business Solutions and founder of Access Point. Ron, thank you so much for being here.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Thank you, Shirley.
This is so exciting. Let's start the conversation with a brief history of Access Point and how did it come about?
Well, that's a great question. You know, a couple of years ago, I was looking at an opportunity to make St. Louis even more of a technology hub. So I formed an alliance of several of the CIOs, chief information officers of large corporations in town, MasterCard, Cigna, Bayer, Ameren, Edward Jones, and a couple of others. And started looking at the opportunities in information technology here in the region over the next 3 years. And what I saw was that there would be 4,500 new jobs in information technology created over the next 3 years, just at the pace that we're on now. And a third of those, 1,500 of those jobs could be filled by entry-level individuals. And that's where the pivot occurred for me. 1,500 career opportunities for entry-level individuals. So that means that we can train 1,500 people for those jobs. And if we're going to train for those jobs, why not very intentionally target underrepresented groups? And so that's what we did. And so we pivoted from a make St. Louis more of a technology hub to let's dramatically increase the diversity in the information technology workforce. And by the way, good things will happen, like St. Louis becoming even more of a technology hub, if we do increase the diversity in the IT workforce. But we're doing that here in St. Louis, and now we're taking it around the country as well.
That is amazing. And why is it so important to make the tech industry more diverse, Ron?
Well, there are a couple of reasons for that. One is, you know, technology is involved with everything these days. And it's important to have a diverse perspective from those who are building the technology. That's part of just about everything we do. And so there's part of it. We've just found that the diverse groups bring more creativity, different points of view. There are just so many business advantages. And then in addition to that, advantage and benefits for our community as well. Hey, I'll tell you a little story if you don't mind.
Sure.
Shirley, just came to mind. You know, my daughter is the veterinarian for the St. Louis Aquarium at Union Station.
Awesome.
And she took me on a backstage tour just a couple of weeks ago. And we walked past the big shark tank with the stingrays and sharks and paddlefish and all sorts of exotic fish. And I said, gee, I guess you have to be really careful about how you combine all the different species of fish in order to just to keep bad things from happening, keep these fish from fighting and eating each other. And she said, no, not at all. No. How do you handle that? We just make sure that they're all well fed. And you know, that's one of the things that comes to mind here. If we make sure people are taken care of, that everyone has access to opportunity, then a lot of our problems go away with education and jobs. And so that's one of the thoughts behind Access Point for me.
So how does the program work, Ron?
Yeah, well, it does. It allows us to take a high school student to a paid apprenticeship, a well-paying apprenticeship within 3 months after graduation. And then from there, they can achieve a full-time, well-paying job in information technology with a major corporation in less than a year from the time that they graduated from high school. And so there are several components of this that are critical to the success of Access Point. And by the way, Access Point comes from something that I heard my friend Art McCoy, Dr. Art McCoy, say. You may know him, Shirley.
Absolutely. He's on the screen right now.
Oh, there's Art. He sure is. And he said, talent is equally distributed. but access to opportunity is not. And so that's where the name Access Point came from for our program, for our initiative. And so the critical points, the key points are that Access Point starts with the jobs. We have jobs that are identified in major corporations in the region, and we create training very specifically to enable our Access Point students to acquire the skills necessary for those specific jobs. So this is a little bit different than if you achieve a degree in information technology, you'll probably be able to get a job. No, this is if you learn these skills over the next 3 months, you're guaranteed a job with a major corporation. It's more of that kind of an approach. So it starts with the jobs, and then starting with the young people in high school. We're starting with high school juniors and seniors, and we're going to work our way back to the earlier and earlier stages of education. But starting with the students when they're young, it's so critical. Here's what I believe, Shirley. I do not believe that we will ever achieve the diversity numbers that we all want unless we start working with the students and the young people early on. Because when they graduate from high school, as you well know, they have some really tough decisions to make, depending upon their financial situation, the circumstances that they're in, and the hard life choices. And for many of these very bright, talented young people, achieving a four-year college degree in the traditional manner is not really an option. The financial pressures, the circumstances are not going to allow it. And so if we can, before we lose them to some other path, put them on a track to a high-paying, life-changing career, then a lot of good things are going to happen.
It is amazing. And you mentioned graduation. You've already had some participants graduate from your program. Tell me about the success rate. What are you seeing at this point?
The success rate is very high. It's almost 100%. There have been we have a 25-person pilot in Cigna Express Scripts here in town. Cigna Express Scripts Evernorth are the same company here in St. Louis. And so Evernorth here in town was our corporate partner for the pilot. And we have 25 students. The first 15 of them have started their paid apprenticeships now. They all graduated successfully from their training. And most of them are at Cigna. Some of them are working for me now. They're moving forward. They're very impressed. I'll tell you something, Shirley, that I've decided. I've been so impressed with the success of the program and the success of these bright young people that I've decided to hire 25 of them myself in the next group that graduates from Access Point.
That's incredible, Ron. And like you said, this is life-changing work, and you are making a difference in the community, and I applaud you for this. So I noticed at the top of the show, we actually had Nellie talking about the program. How did you get him involved in this?
Yeah, Nellie has just been, I've been so impressed with Nellie. He truly is committed to St. Louis and doing good things for this region. And so a friend of mine worked with Nellie's business manager, Patricia Shannon. Patricia Shannon worked with Nellie's business manager, made that introduction. We shared the Access Point program. Mike Chafin, Nellie's business manager, said, I think Nellie would like to support this. I think he would be interested in this. And so we shared it with Nellie, and he was just fully on board. And he came to our kickoff event. He's so patient. He talked with, he just posed for picture after picture, talked with all the students, the teachers, the parents, the corporate people who were there. And I'll say again, I was really impressed with Nellie. He's very entrepreneurial, very business minded, very community minded, and he's just been a great supporter.
That is so awesome. And what an inspiration for the young people in the program to see someone like Nellie supporting them and supporting this program. But let's talk a little bit more about the business leaders in the community, Ron. What are you hearing from them in terms of the program and why it's so desperately needed?
Well, that's another great question. And so The three major components are the business leaders, the high school districts, and the higher educational organizations. And so St. Louis Community College and UMSL have been great partners. We're working with 17 school districts, and we're working with a number of major corporations. And you know, they all want more diversity in their technology workforces. They all want more diversity. They've been great partners. That it's just interesting to see how that there are things in place, rules, regulations, policies that large corporations have that I don't know those policy. I don't believe those policies were designed to impede progress with diversity, but by golly, they are. And so we're working with these organizations and helping them understand how to make adjustments that will open doors. Things like not requiring a four-year college degree before you can consider someone for a career in information technology, because just that simple requirement eliminates the many of the folks that were that are part of this Access Point program, the bright young people who may not be able to achieve a degree in the traditional manner. But I'll tell you what, education is part of this program. It's not just a boot camp, a programming coding camp. It's the beginning of an educational as well as a career journey. And so think of it as these students, they now have a living wage. They're earning a good income, working for a supportive corporation with tuition reimbursement, and so they can continue. In fact, by the time they finish the Access Point training in just a few months, they will have earned 15 hours of college credit. So they're already on their way.
That is incredible. Ron Doherty, CEO of Doherty Business Solutions and founder of Access Point. Thank you so much for your time and the work you're doing in the community, changing lives. We appreciate you.
It's a great privilege. Thank you, Shirley.
And straight ahead on The Pulse, teachers visiting students at home, how the special trip helps them accomplish their academic goals. Stay with us. We are back in a moment.